Class 8 Geography Chapter 4 Mineral Resources Part 1 The main topics that we are going to learn in this chapter are classification of minerals, mining, method of mining, distribution of mineral resources in the world, distribution of mineral resources in India, conservation of mineral resources. Now, what is minerals? Minerals are the building blocks of rocks. Minerals are an important part of our daily lives. It is hardly anything around us that does not contain any minerals in it. Minerals are present in all the rocks found in the lithosphere. Rocks are made up of one or more minerals. The amount of minerals found in a rock varies from region to region, one place to another. A rock that has a large concentration of minerals is called the ore of that mineral. Now, some of you will have doubt, what is ore? A mineral that contains metal that is valuable enough to be mined. Now, what is mined? Extracted from the sources. Removing. Now, these are the characteristics of minerals. Minerals are non-living, naturally occurring substances that are concentrated in a particular area. It is found in a particular areas. Minerals are unevenly distributed over the earth's surface. It has no leveled. Any level we can find the minerals. The mineral resources are exhaustible in nature. They are also exhaustible in nature. Minerals have a definite chemical position and specific physical properties. Human beings have found various minerals from the beginning of prehistoric times. When we go through the age-old civilization, we can see the people from then onwards using the minerals, and they have also put different ages that what they found. First one is Stone Age, then came Copper Age, Bronze Age, Iron Age and Steel Age. So that the way they have divided according to their discovery. Now we will learn classification of minerals. Minerals are classified into two broad categories. First one is according to their formation. First one is mineral formed through organic. Second one is mineral formed through inorganic. Minerals formed through organic formed millions of years ago from the remains of the living things such as plants and animals. They are also called mineral fuels or fossil fuels, and there we can see the minerals that is we get is coal and petrol. Minerals formed through inorganic means minerals are formed from non-living things. They are further categorized into metallic and non-metallic minerals. For examples, we can say iron, copper, gypsum and limestone. Now, gypsum means a white colorful mineral, especially people use for cement, white cements and plaster place, they use it. Next one is metallic minerals. The minerals from which the metals such as iron, gold, copper are obtained, known as metallic minerals. The minerals removed from the metals like iron, gold, copper. They are also are found in ores, and they are very. These are removed metals that are taken from the in igneous and metamorphic rocks. In this igneous metamorphic rocks, we can remove all these ores, and they are these minerals are very hard. Also, they are luster. Luster means shining, and it is very shining. We know that gold and iron and copper are very shining, and people we use it. Metallic minerals divide into two: ferrous minerals and non-ferrous minerals. Now, the ferrous minerals are rich in iron content, like iron ore, chromist, and manganese. The non-ferrous minerals contains no iron, but they have got other metals such as copper, silver, lead, and gold. Other one is non-metallic minerals. The minerals which do not have metallic content in them are called non-metallic minerals. In these minerals include, we can say, nitrate, sulfurous, mica, talc, salt, coal. All these are non-metallic minerals. They are generally found in the sedimentary rocks. Next one is mining. What is mining? Mining is a process of extraction of the mineral resources from the earth. Now, what is meaning of extraction? Removing the minerals, removing from the earth. That is called mining. Now, some things we must know while minerals are few points what we must know how to remove the mining minerals. Now, quality and quantity of minerals. Quantity and quality of minerals should be in high. Minerals found in lesser quantities are not worth mining, and due to high cost of extraction, we have to do a lot of extraction of to remove the minerals, and it is not very easy. Next one is accessibility to the region. The region where the minerals ore is located should be easily accessible, easily to removable. We can reach and remove those things. The regions that are densely forest and excessively sambada cannot be mined for the easy. Soil soft, sambada means soft, very soft, then we cannot remove the soft and very muddy soil. We cannot remove the minerals from there. Depth of the minerals. It is easy to extract minerals when they are found in the upper layers, and it is more economical as well. But when you go deep down, it is not very easy to extract the minerals, and it is very expensive too. Next one is shaft mining. It is people who may extract minerals. They make deep holes and they remove the minerals. Very deep holes, and removing the minerals are called shaft mining. A shaft mining has many underground chambers. Next one is drilling. It is the process of extracting mineral oil and natural gas by digging deep wells. They are called drilling. Drilling is performed in various ways depending upon the size of the opening and type of rock that has to be penetrated. That is according to the size and the level and the place they have to dig do the drilling. Next one is distribution of minerals. The distribution of minerals found not in a same level. This is found in an unlevel all throughout the world, and this is because of the rocks are found in different types and shapes and structures. The quality of the minerals found in different places also varies. Some places we see the minerals are in abundance, lot, but some places we see very little. The quality of the minerals will be very little. That is why there is a distribution of the minerals are found different in different continents, different countries, different places. Iron is the most commonly used metal. The main ores of iron are magnetite, hematite, and limonite. They have various amount of iron content in them. They have got a lot of iron content. Magnetite has the highest amount of iron content. Hematite is the most commonly used iron ore. Iron is mixed with other substances to produce steel. And we know steel is used for many purposes. Machinery, transport equipment, agriculture tools, even the things that we use in our daily life, iron is used. And steel also used. Major iron produced countries are Russia, the more iron producing countries, Russia, China, European, and the USA, Brazil, South Africa, and India. We are also not bad in producing iron. Next one is copper. Copper has highly conductivity. Conductivity means to hold on electricity, the power to hold on the electricity. Therefore, it is mainly used in electrical industries. To make electrical wires and appliances and wires in the electrical things. When we make the copper is the wire inside, they use it for the use of all these plugs and things. When we make and use for our household, for the houses. And it is also used for producing various alloys such as brass and bronze. The largest producer of copper in the world is Chile. Now other countries which produces copper is USA, Peru, Russia, Zimbabwe, Canada, and Poland.